Hey everybody, Matt here with more Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild DLC. Decided to just pick up, you know, right where I was at. First that, then. Quite a bit on the way, but a lot better than last time. So, yeah, I need shields. Yeah, it turned out I could have killed that if I had just held on to one of those, ancient arrows, I could have killed that silver lion in a single hit. I didn't think that they would die that quickly. So, but just to be safe though, I had my my Lionel bow equipped, so I fired three of them point blank while he was in stasis, so. I think this might be the last floor, but I'm not certain. Oh, it was! Oh, finally! Just noticed it's playing the shrine music. That's probably really loud. I forgot to adjust my volume before doing this. So you guys are probably getting double audio from my game music, but eh, it's quiet enough. All right. This better be like an unbreakable. Oh, there's fun. Better be an unbreakable master sword. I'm gonna be really upset if it's not. Actually, I have a feeling this is gonna get kind of loud, so I will turn it down. Oh, thank goodness the volume overlay does not appear in the video. All right. Is beyond question. We are the ones who prepared this trial, following a revelation from the goddess Hylia. To the one who has overcome the trial with the sword, you have proven your hand worthy of the legendary Master Sword. Now that the hero has gained the power necessary to combat the calamity, our sacred duty has been fulfilled. Chosen hero. Awakened Master Sword, now boasting its true splendor.
Oh no, they're fading.
Protect the Kingdom of Hyrule, for now and for always. Ah, but before we do, let's look at my ending gear. How much I have left of it. And, might as well. And I might as well give myself an extra stamina boost. Oh, no, that wasn't an extra stamina boost. Dang it. Oh well. Yeah, and as it turns out, you can't use these either. I thought of that. They weren't gonna have it though. Not even like a one-time use each. That would have been nice, but never once used any of those abilities. So out of fear of not knowing how to replenish them. Same reason I haven't used the Hylene Shield, although I did hear that there is a way to... restore it, I believe, in Terrytown, it was? That little village that we helped build over in the Akala region? Surprised I didn't have to fight a Dark Link at the end of this. I'm actually a little disappointed. It would have been nice. Can't win them all. I can win anything that tries to fight against me. Alright, let's see it. It better not just be another plus 10 attack. Huh. Wait, it's glowing. So is it like boosted attack power at all times now? Finally returned. Your mind, body, and soul are now ready to wield the Master Sword at its full potential. Never fail to impress. Master Sword, the legendary sword that seals the darkness, a blade that can combat the Calamity. Link's triumph over the trial of the sword has awakened its true splendor. So, plus 68. Now you are truly one with that sword of yours. I must say, its sacred glow suits you well. As ever, I shall watch over your journey from here. Princess, I'm certain Hyrule's princess is pleased with your accomplishments as well. That's right, canonically, I have not beaten Ganon yet. Yeah, it's glowing like at all times. Let's see. You conquered the merciless trial of the sword. You now have the physical and mental strength necessary to use the Master Sword to its full potential. Princess Zelda is no doubt quite happy with your achievement. Well, I know when it's glowing, it has a greatly increased level of durability. Let's test it out on some trees, though. Yeah. Gotta say, I was in a bad spot at the end of that last episode. With how embarrassing that defeat was, how close I was, and just how much I underestimated some of the weapons in my inventory. And overestimated my ability to fight the Silver Lionel wielding a spear like that. I don't know what happened, but some of those flurry rush prompts did not occur. Yeah. It is just 60. Really didn't want to wait 4 more days to make this video. Also, because I didn't want to forget what I was going to be up against. Something that arrived in the mail today for me. This, the Fierce Deity Boots. So, you know. It's nice to see that they're not the Master Sword up effect like the rest of them. Although, I don't know what happens if you make a complete set, since this is first day and, you know, amiibo once a day. So, really disappointed with all of these still. Still very, very, very so much time collecting star fragments. I mean, I don't really think there's the Deity outfit piece that I have so far even wanted a star fragment. I was kind of expecting that, but with all the other amiibo here. But that one may be special, because I know we also have the Skyward Sword outfit, which is literally just slightly more washed out version of the Twilight Princess outfit. So. Dang, this thing has cut down a lot of trees so far. Go ahead and pick some fights. A tree to fall. Oh, what? Didn't do any damage to him. Trial of the Sword should not really be a trial and error kind of thing, which it feels like they did. I know I tend to hoard resources in games anyway, which is already kind of a problem. And I'm very much a collector type player. I will tough it out and not use any healing items for as absolutely long as I can. But especially trying to reserve all my weapon strength, like not knowing what I'm gonna be up against, and just I don't know. I feel like they could have designed it better, but something. one, and I'm like, I didn't do anything. There was a talisk right over here. Well, the Master Sword is really holding up. I mean, this going a while. I'm gonna keep playing and commenting though, and until oh, there's a silver one right there. Why do I have that? Oh, because I have like six of them. No. Where did the outfit go? Where are the pants for that? Oh! Oh, move them over here. Oh, that's weird. Oh. Would have been nice if they weren't exactly equivalent to the, to the barbarian armor. Can't wait to see what that sword does, though. I wonder if it'll work like the Wind Cleaver, where it sends out, like, shockwaves and, like, breaks really, really easily. Satisfying as this would be. Yep, let's see. I got it for up. Yeah, okay. So that looks like about to be the This is about the radius right here. I mean, you can obviously see those stones right in front of me. Up there. That's how the Korok mask works. One other thing to do. Probably not even worth it though. But, you guys see my ending stats before I go on my little crusade to find all those stupid Koroks. So yeah, all the shrines, no spirit orbs left over. I opted to have the 3 extra heart containers instead of the 3 extra stamina vessels. And then, of course my rupee count is ridiculous. Not even sure how I got that many rupees. Really don't know how. 597 Koroks out of 900 total. Still only 60? Ah, that's a little disappointing. I figured it would double in attack power. Moon, Alice, to the moon. Oh. Master Sword does in fact break. How about that? Well then, I guess that means I need to switch to these. Come on, turn around. Come on, dummy. I know those will obliterate them even without like a critical hit, but... cooldown is different. Nope. Still regular cooldown. Still, that increases weapon durability. Oops. I broke my bow too. Oh. I guess that's it for now. Until the actual story DLC comes out. So, until next time, take care, everyone.